Hello friends, so today we are going to discuss another LeetCode problem. The problem is DI string match. So what is given in this problem statement? So instead of going through the whole description, I will quickly tell you. So here the input is a string which contains only two kind of characters. It can be the combination of I and D, or it can be like simply I or DDD or DI. So that kind of input is given. So, and we are given with the two constraint. When the character is I, then we have to form, so the output is we have to form an array. So in the array, when the character is I, so the constraint is like the ith of I is less than the ith of I plus 1. And when the character is D, then the constraint is a eighth of I element is greater than eighth of I plus one element. Okay, and the size of the output array will be lying from 0 to n. So n is the length of the string. So let's take an example one. Okay, so here we are given the string that is a IDID, and the expected output is 0 4 1 3 2. Okay, so if we think, like if we consider the second input string, that is a I. So here the inputs, the output string or the output array is like 0 1 2 3. So looking at the input and output, we can get to know one relation. Let's consider this way. If we consider like the based on the constraint, the whenever we get the I as a character, so I will start from 0 to length of the string. So here if you look at the example 2, you can get to know this relation. Every time the I gets incremented by 1. So for the first I it is 0, for the second I it becomes 1, for the third I it becomes 2, and again for the last relation, because whenever we get here as a 2, then as per the constraint number 1, the aith element should be lesser than the a of I plus 1th element. So that's why they have added the 3 as well. So here what we can see is like the I should start from 0 to n, that is in the ascending order, and the D starts from n to 0th order. So as soon as we get the I, so what we need to do is we need to set the value, or we need to put that ith value in the output array and increment the ith value. Similarly, when we see the D as a character, so we have to put the dth value in the output array and decrement it by 1. So let's take the coding part now. So here what I have done is I have declared one result array which size is greater than which size is the length of the string plus 1. Why plus 1? Because we have to append the extra one element to fulfill the relationship, that is with the a of i is less than a of I plus 1 and the a of I greater than a of I plus 1. Okay, to satisfy those conditions, I have added the plus 1, extra plus 1 over here. Then what I have done is I have set the ith value which starts from 0 and the dth value, that is the length of the string. Okay, so here what I am doing is I am simply iterating the string with the help of two character array function. So every time I get the character one by one. So let's consider the first example, that is a IDID. Okay, so first it will detect the character as a I. That time our ith value is 0, so it will simply, I will form it over here. So what it will do, it will simply add the 0 over here and the ith value become 1 at this stage. Next time we will come to this dth character. So for the dth character, initially it is 4, so we will simply put the 4 as a value. Next time we will decrement the d as well, so now d becomes, in our case I becomes 1 and d becomes 3. So next time we will again detect the ith character. For the ith character, we will simply put the value of the ith character, that is a 1, and again what we will do is we will increment the ith value to 2. Okay, and at the last we will detect the character as a d. So what we need to do is we just need to add that dth value over here, that is a 3, okay? And finally, and we need to decrement its value by 1, that is it becomes 2, okay? Finally, it will come out of this for loop, and at the last stage what we need to do is finally for this jth character we simply put the ith value, because what will happen is whenever this 3 is there, so after the 3, the if we consider 3 as a ith index, so the ith plus 1 index has to be lesser, so we will simply put the ith value, that is a 2. So this way we will get the expected output 04132, which is the expected one. Okay, so let me run this program and we will see the output of this program. Okay, so we have got the successful output here, the solution is accepted. At the runtime it says 3 milliseconds. Okay, now if we see the number of test cases, it has passed, so it has passed all the 95 test cases. Now coming to the space complexity and the time complexity of this algorithm, so we can consider the space complexity, that is the length of the string, because we have formed the integer array of the length of that string plus one character, that is a, so we can consider it as a length of the string, that is a space complexity. And if you consider the time complexity part, so we are simply iterating through this string only once, so the whatever the is the length, so let's consider the length of the string is n, so big of n is the time complexity of this algorithm. If you want the solution of this algorithm, so I have posted the solution on the GitHub, and I have mentioned the GitHub link in the description section below, so you can refer it. And if you like this video, please like this video, share this video, comment this video, and I will catch you in the next one. Thanks for watching.